Thank you for tuning in to the Rap Palette, another Rap Palette news. So now, Diddy had a birthday party the other day. It's 50. Time flies. But which everybody was naming it. Rap, Joe, it's all sorts of people was there. But two interesting figures that was there as well was Jay-Z and Kanye. Now, there's two things I'm going to talk about this. One was featured by Genius, and they said it reportedly that Kanye West and Jay-Z has finally settled the title lawsuit, and they're on good terms. You know what I mean? Sometimes business is business. And I'm going to get into this, then I'll get into my opinion about some stuff, okay? Now, Kanye left Tidal Platform in 2007 for a contract. Over the weekend, Jay-Z and Kanye were spotted at Diddy's 50th birthday party, where they appeared to be back in friendly terms, according to as they're totally cool with each other, resolving the 2017 Tidal lawsuit earlier this year. Kanye left Tidal June 2017 after reportedly accusing Jay-Z of platforming him more than $3 million at the time. TMZ reported that Kanye had two main sticking. Not only was he not paid a bonus for driving a huge jump in Tidal subscription with The Life of Pablo, but he also wasn't reimbursed for the album musicals. In November, the Chicago native streamed his first opera, Nebuchadnezzar, exclusively on Tidal, according to TMZ. He reportedly being partnered with the streaming service for more exclusive content. The report has added that while Kanye and Jay have moved past their business issues and repaired their fractured personal relationship, we shouldn't expect the Watch the Throne 2 to come anytime soon. Genius previously broke down the history of their relationship. Meanwhile, Jay has recently made his discography available outside of Tidal after bringing his albums back to Apple Music in May. The Brooklyn mogul also released his solo catalog on Spotify earlier this month to celebrate his 50th. So it still looked like that, but they would never be the way they was before. To be honest with you, they were never cool in the beginning. Kanye's always been Dame Jazz's man, Dame Dash, and he came under Dame. Dame signed him, and then him and Dame are still cool today. You know what I mean? I think Kanye has this big brother syndrome for Jay-Z, which a lot of people don't. You know what I mean? Jay-Z has this polarizing figure where everybody looks up to him, but Jay-Z's for himself, and that which is not a problem. No disrespect to him. You know what I mean? He is a god himself. You know what I mean? But Rakim is a god himself. Nobody praises him. His name doesn't get mentioned. Top five, dead or alive. So the meeting was still kind of awkward, and you can tell that because there have been memes floating all over the place, which looks crazy. 50 Cent on his page, which I'm going to feature in the video, said this is exactly what you asked for. I'm asking who all is coming over, and his face was very, very, like he wasn't even caring who was here. So this is the point that we asked you. There's no friends in this business. You have to take care of who you get the bag for you and your kids, but you also got to stand up for yourself as well. This is the prime example of what it is. You know, I mean, people do business and not always going to be the same. But it's good to see Kanye out here. But, you know, these are polarizing things in their own right. You know what I mean? Kanye's fans are different from Jay-Z. So, you know what I mean? I understand that. So, hope you like this news update. Like and subscribe. Press the notification. Share. If you can't donate, just share this as much as you can. You can boost this up to 1,000, to 10,000, and 100,000, million. Take over.